Hello Internet, Artie Lady here, and in this video I'm gonna show how I 3D printed and finished the head of the T-800 model of the robot from the Terminator movie series. In this video I'm gonna focus on smoothing, painting and finishing, and in the next video I'm gonna show how to install electronic components in the model. So this 3D model was printed in my new 3D printer called Tevo Tarantula. I bought the large bed version with dual extruder and using the Titan extruder. This 3D printer is an FDM printer, or a fused deposition modeling printer, and it basically heats and melts some sort of plastic filament, and it deposits this plastic layer by layer until the whole model is printed. And for printing this model here, I used a biodegradable plastic filament known as polylactic acid or PLA. The best resolution that this printer can handle is 0.1 millimeters of height per layer. I printed this model in the best resolution that this printer supports, and I decreased the printing speed to improve the quality of the print. The 3D print of the base took about 19 hours, and the printing of the head took about 65 hours. I have downloaded the original version of this 3D model in the website called Thingiverse, but I did some modifications to this model before printing. So the main modifications I did was to separate the head from the base of this model so I could print them in two separate parts. And I have also made a hole in the base of this model so I can insert batteries inside this base, and these batteries will provide energy for the LED lights that I'm planning to put in the eyes of the Terminator. I'll post my modified version of this model in Thingiverse, and I'll leave a link in the video description in case you want to download and print this 3D model as well. Now let's go directly to the finishing of our model. So for starting the finishing process of this model, I'm gonna take this rotary tool and I'm gonna start to sand the surface of this model to remove certain imperfections that remained in the model after the printing process. Some of these imperfections can be remaining support material parts that are still attached to the model even after cleaning out the supports, or any additional imperfections caused by fluctuations in the temperature or in the filament quality during the printing process. After using the rotary tool to remove the large imperfections of the model, now I'm gonna switch to sandpaper between 200 grit and 400 grit to remove smaller imperfections without removing any details from the model. It's important to do this cleaning before applying the primer, because although the primer can hide some imperfections, it has its limitations and it won't work on large imperfections. Sanding helps a lot to clean up all these imperfections caused by extra extrusion. But in the case of under extrusion, where there is material missing in the model or there is a hole in the model, then we need to use another method to cover these imperfections. And the most efficient method I have found so far is to use this epoxy putty. So once I mix both parts of this epoxy, I'm gonna have about 1 hour to work with it before it solidifies. If I want to make this epoxy more soft, I can just add a little bit of water and the modeling gets much easier. And even before the epoxy solidifies, we can start to use sandpaper to smooth some uneven surfaces in the model. And finally, we can apply a little bit of water to clean out the residues of epoxy that may have resulted from sanding. So I'll keep repeating these steps until I remove most of the largest imperfections before I can apply the primer. The amount of imperfections that your model is gonna have will depend also on the printing quality. So for printing this model, I tried to set the best resolution of 0.10 millimeters and a slower speed for getting a better printer result with the minimal amount of imperfections. After you cover all the holes with epoxy and you sand it, the surface of the model is gonna look like this. This part of the finishing is very time consuming, so I had to accelerate and summarize a little bit the video showing this process, otherwise this video would turn out too long. Now let's finally start applying the primer. The primer that I typically use is one of these sandable primers. These primers are usually used to fill gaps and cover imperfections. So I start by applying one layer of primer, then I wait until the primer layer dries. The drying time will be different for each brand, in my case it's 30 to 60 minutes of drying. And after this layer dries, I take my 200 grit and 400 grit sandpaper and I start sanding very thoroughly until I remove most of the imperfections. For not spreading too much dust, I recommend that you apply a little bit of water to the sandpaper or to the model. And I'll keep repeating this process of applying primer and sanding for at least 3 times. The number of times that you're gonna repeat this process will depend on the number of imperfections and the size of the imperfections of your model. And after sanding each layer and before applying the next layer of primer, it's very important to clean very well the surface of your model. So I usually wash it and dry it very well after sanding before applying the next layer of primer. After I did this process of applying primer and sanding at least 3 times for our Terminator head, now I'm gonna follow the same process for the base of this model. So I'm doing the same thing again, applying primer, waiting until it dries, sanding, and repeating this process for 3 times, or more if it's necessary. I'm gonna leave in the description of this video a list with all the materials that I use for the finishing of this model, and I'm gonna show a list where you can buy these materials as well. There is still a little bit of a remaining support in this little cavity that I created to put the batteries, so I'm gonna use a rotary tool and a cutting tool to remove the support residues. The support material is always a little difficult to remove. You can always make them easier to remove if you go to the printing settings and decrease their density, but if you decrease the density too much, then there are certain parts that will not be printed very well. After you did a lot of primer and sanding, if you want to make the surface of this model smoother, you can use a finer grit sandpaper. It can be a 1000 or 1500 grit sandpaper, like the one that I'm using here. So for finishing our smoothing of the model, I'm gonna apply this fine grit sandpaper to the base and to the head of our T800 model. It's nice to leave the head very smooth because it gives a very shiny and bright effect in the metallic paint. And after this fine grit sanding, I'm gonna wash and clean this model very well one last time and let it dry before applying the paint. Now let's finally start painting. And for giving that metallic effect to our model, first we need to apply an even layer of black paint. The paint that I'm using here is an acrylic paint and it's the glossy black color with a glossy or wet effect. So I'm applying this paint with airbrush and I'm gonna apply a number of layers that is enough to cover the whole model. Usually 2 or 3 layers are enough, but don't forget to dry the previous layer before applying the next. I usually wait at least 1 hour after applying each layer of acrylic paint. This waiting time may be too long, but I prefer to be safe than sorry. The correct texture of an acrylic paint to be used with an airbrush is usually like the milk texture. If the paint is too concentrated, it's gonna cause clogs in the airbrush. If the paint is too diluted, then it's gonna leak too much and it's not gonna cover the model very well. And for finishing the painting, I'm gonna use this metallic paint. The color is mirror chrome. Here it's very important to be careful and not add too much paint. If you add too much metallic paint, then this final layer will not be shiny anymore. And the secret for the metallic effect is to use a very shiny and glossy layer of black paint under the metallic paint. As more shiny is the black paint, more shiny will be the metallic effect. Now that the head is painted, I'm gonna do the same thing for the base of this model. Now that the painting is done, the next step is to install the electronic components of our T800 model. But I will leave the installation of the electronic parts to another video, otherwise this video would be too long. So this is the final result after painting and installing the LED lights in the eyes of our T800 model. So stay tuned for the next video showing how to install the electronic parts of this model. Don't forget to leave a like if you like this video and to subscribe to this channel to receive notifications about the next videos. I'll see you next time. Bye bye. When I started to record this video, I was living in Flagstaff, Arizona, and unfortunately I had to stop the video for a few months because of the winter and the snow, so it's a little difficult to work with the hands frozen, but soon we're gonna continue this video. I promise.